No refuge can save the hireling and slave from the terror of light or the gloom of the grave. And the star-spangled banner in triumph doth wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. So did you stand up? So today I'm going to talk a little bit about the history of the national anthem at sporting events and respect for the American flag. Well, that song you heard me singing at the intro to this video was the little known second verse to the Star Spangled Banner, aka the US national anthem. That song was first played at a professional sporting event in September of 1918 at the first game of the World Series during the First World War. But that song didn't become the national anthem for the United States until 1931. By the end of the Second World War, the playing of the Star Spangled Banner at professional sporting events becomes a national tradition, particularly in the NFL. Now, this tradition increased likely because of first the introduction of large sound systems and patriotism after World War II. Now, about as fast as the national anthem was being adopted as a tradition at sporting events, a new tradition was springing up, complaining about people's behavior during the national anthem. Now, behavior during the national anthem got so bad that in 1954, the general manager of the Baltimore Orioles stopped playing it altogether. Now, that lasted for about a month. Now, while the anthem continued to be a game day fixture, the players generally stayed in the locker room for it. In fact, mandating players to be on the field during the national anthem didn't start until 2009. It isn't now, and it's never been, a regulation in the NFL to stand during the playing of the national anthem. But is it the law to stand for the national anthem? The United States does have a code for how you're supposed to behave during the playing of the national anthem. Section 301 of the United States Code says, during a rendition of the national anthem, people should face the flag and stand at attention with your hand over your heart, except for uniformed military personnel who should stand saluting. If there is no flag, people are supposed to stand facing the source of the music and behave the same way. So if you're a US citizen and you didn't stand during the intro to this video, your behavior was not up to code. And I don't know how you can call yourself a patriot. Now, there are separate codes for the national anthem and for the flag. Now, let's talk about the flag. Is it breaking the law to disrespect the US flag? In 1989, the Supreme Court in Texas versus Johnson declared that the US government could not stop people from desecrating the flag. Now, despite the decision of the Supreme Court, the legislation brought the Protection of the Flag Act of 1989, which made it illegal to desecrate the flag, regardless of one's motive. And people protested and started burning flags to get the issue back to the Supreme Court. So in 1990, the Supreme Court ruled again in the United States versus Eichmann, desecrating the flag was constitutionally protected free speech. So when Donald Trump says that people should be fired for taking the knee during the national anthem because it's disrespectful to the flag, he's behaving in a way that could be considered unconstitutional. Fortunately, we know that the internet is full of the guardians of free speech. Hopefully, in the coming days and weeks and months, we'll be hearing from all of them about how the behavior of someone like Colin Kaepernick and the hundreds of professional sports players who decided to take a knee in protest of Donald Trump's words are behaving in accordance to the Constitution. They're being just about as an American can be. So that's it for this video. Like it if you like it. Share, comment, subscribe. This is Reg signing off. Love yourselves. Peace. And I love myself.